Well, you talked about light therapy earlier, especially someone like me where we have 5 hours of gray outside. We don't even get, I think today we got sunshine for the first time. I don't know how long. But so how is that? I mean, that's still magnetic signals, right? Or
Correct, but it's of a spectrum that is tuned to our mitochondria. That's what we're supposed to have. And even if it's gray outside, if you take a spectrometer, you're still going to get the spectrum of the sun. It's still going to be there, right? So you
okay.
don't have to have a whole lot of it. All life on the planet is governed by the sun. Everything. Our weather's made by the sun, not by humans. I mean, everything. It's amazing. But depending upon the zenith angle of where you are geographically, latitude will determine if you're getting into the ultraviolet or not. Okay, where you're currently at, you're not getting any UV for nothing. But you need UV, okay, for proper metabolism, immunity, and everything. Synthesis of prohormone D, some people call it vitamin D.
Yeah, so is that an alternative to the light therapy? Because I take vitamin D.
Yes, you can, but it has to be the right form and the right dose. You don't want too much or too little.
Okay.
Okay.
So what would be the right form?
Well, it always needs to be D3,
Mm-hmm.
cholecalciferol. I prefer it to come from sheep wool, lanolin, that's been hit with UV light, as opposed to artificial oil like cod liver oil or something like that, that they just, because remember, cod live under the water. They're not solar based animals, though they have the vitamin D in there. I prefer to get some land mammal vitamin D. So they comb it, this cholesterol out of sheep's wool lanolin, and then they can hit it with UV, and that's better. But you can take a D3 supplement. And I recommend a good dose daily is 5,000 IU
Yeah,
in
that's
national units. It sounds high, but that's like micrograms. If you convert that over, it's very little, and you'll never get toxicity even close to that, no matter what anybody tells you. But you got to quantify to you, that might not be enough. You need to get a proper vitamin D panel done, which is a marker called 25OH. Vitamin D, 25 hydroxy vitamin D. That's your storage form of D. And that number needs to be somewhere between 35 and 55. 35 and 55, that's the range. I like to keep mine around 55. You don't get any much better for getting it 70 or 100 or anything like that. It only becomes toxic if it's above 200. Now, all of this I'm quoting you comes from the guy, Dr. Hollick. He looks like Mr. Burns from The Simpsons. Great guy. He discovered the marker. Okay. He is Mr. Vitamin D. He's the bomb.com. Okay. When it comes to vitamin D and everything I'm telling you is that. Now, clinically, I've experienced that as well. So if you're not in a UV enriched environment in a day, it's beneficial to take a range of somewhere right around a minimum of 1,000 IU, but that really just doesn't cover it. 2,000 IU to 5,000, depending upon your geographic location. See, everything is based upon the individual or what I call the biochemical individuality of the patient. So it ranges what a person needs, right? So when you have ranges of labs, right, you're going to be like, well, some people are, we come up with ranges in medicine based upon a sample of a seemingly healthy population. Some of us need to be on the higher end of the range. Some need to be dead middle, some can be other. You got to find out what works for you through testing and quantification. So that's the litmus. I can't just tell everybody, here's the universal dose. Not everybody is the same.
Right. No, I get that. And I know even like now when I've been a little bit more run down with my son sick, I think I need more. I've definitely felt like a little seasonal change in the attitude. But
Yeah.
Kim wants to know what about sunscreens and sunglasses? Are they blocking out the needed?
Don't use either.
Okay, I'm a redhead. I have a problem with that. I'm going to the Canary Islands in a month. There's
I got
no
you covered.
way. What
That
about skin cancer? Like, hello.
UV light does not cause skin cancer. It's not true. Okay. It can contribute to it if you burn in excess. But to
I
say that
burn
UV light,
time and the
I
sun.
got you. I'm going to tighten that up. UV
Okay.
light does not cause cancer. if you, any radiation in excess to a weakened tissue that loses tolerance can lead to cell differentiation and DNA damage, ergo cancer. Okay. It's just like saying cell phones don't cause cancer. They can, and they can contribute to. I use a cell phone, doesn't mean I'm going to get cancer. So I want the balanced understanding to be out there. UV light is needed for so many things in the body and functions, hormones, neurotransmitters, a ton of things. It's about balance, the right dose. Okay, so the other thing is never burn, never burn. Okay, so you don't want to burn. People say, well, I will burn if I don't put on sunscreen, if you don't have clothing on it. So your first option is a physical barrier, sleeves, drapey stuff, floppy hats. Shade. Imagine that. Okay. That's the first thing. Now, there are times if you are at altitude skiing and you got it bouncing off, whatever, I don't want to burn either. I love having fabulous skin. Okay. So I'm not, and I live in Florida. Okay. But the key here is it's about balance and dosage. Same thing like the 3D approach, right? So you got to think about disconnect, get out from on the sun to burning you. Get some distance between you and it. In other words, like on seven, and then limit the duration. So there are fair skinned people. I'm Irish as the day is long too. Okay. Thank goodness I didn't get the red.
Not Irish, but I am a redhead.
Oh, I was born. I did have red hair when I was born, but, you can build up tolerance to it. So what you don't want to do is go, I burn. So I'm going to sunscreen and then get out in the sun. Well, then now you're putting toxins in your skin. Okay. There are great.
I didn't know that, but like I'm a surfer, and you know, when I'm